the modern hip hop channel. It is DJ Bonics with my old good friend, Pinoy brother, an all-around great guy. Yeah. We got my man Pilo in the building,
man. What's good, man? I'm happy to be in Minnesota.
Yeah, this is not your first time here, right?
No, I might have been here maybe like two or three times.
And what were you doing here?
I came here with g-eazy and I Am Sue and E40 once, and then I came here with Skizzy Mars once.
Right.
And I came here with Skizzy Mars 2016, and I think I was here with G 2015.
Right. And it sounds like you returned the favor to all those dudes because now they're all on your album right now, More Than Anything, which came out early this year. Congratulations,
man. It's cool just to see how like all the work you put in and all the like time you spend on music,
right?
And it's kind of like now everything's kind of like fleshing itself out and like, you know what I'm saying,
right?
Doing
what's crazy
solid.
Is though that me and you kind of have a history.
Yeah,
you kind of been around the gang. Yeah. And you toured with us when I Am Sue was on tour with us back. Big shout out to HBK.
Yeah.
And you actually have produced songs for Wiz early in the game and I Am Sue when I Am Sue did some collabs with Wiz. So like how did that feel being that? Like that was probably like 6 years ago.
I think 2014.
Okay, 2014.
I think it was 2013, 2014.
Right.
But it was, you know what I'm saying? Like being able to work with Wiz, like I think I was with Wiz on his maybe 26th birthday.
Right.
I think we literally, like, that was the first beat I ever played was About Me. That was the first beat I was just like, all right, this is our first beat, boom. And then they instantly recorded to it like that day.
Right. Which is one of the Wiz classic joints.
So they recorded that. It was like Me, Problem, Sue, Wiz, they were all in the studio, and then we recorded that. They recorded that song that night. They took it to the club, played it at the club,
right?
And it was cool.
Amazing, man! Congratulations to you, man! Yeah. And the story's cool. I actually didn't really know that you were like you ball like that.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
college basketball.
Yeah, I could play. I could play a little bit.
Yeah.
I could play a little bit. I'm not the best, but I could get out there and run a little bit.
Right, and then you decided to like kind of take producing more seriously because you saw some of the fame that I Am Sue was getting.
Yeah.
And now you're here, man, with the album.
Yeah.
Dope album.
Yeah.
Put Me On Something with E40.
Yeah.
Such a dope track.
Yeah.
You got Skizzy on that
Skizzy
as well.
On there.
The track with G-Eazy is one of my favorites.
Yeah,
Feel Good.
Yeah.
And so how's it feel just to like, to you've grown up in the Bay where you've seen Too Short and E40 and then even like seeing G-Eazy and seeing all these cats come up and now you're up there.
Yeah. Like it's cool because like, you know what I'm saying? I've been around all those like people and I've been around all those people's success. So like, for me to kind of like take the things that I could like put into whatever I'm doing, like I've learned so much, you know what I'm saying, being around all those cats, you know what I'm saying.
Right.
So it's a blessing to be here, you know what I'm saying. So,
right. And dude, just a lot of the things that I've been seeing you do, the Nike ad, which is so dope.
Yeah.
So you're on a Nike ad, for the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah.
So how does that feel? I mean, growing up,
it's just crazy to be able to represent. You know what I'm saying? Just because, you know, the Warriors are so big right now, and to be part of that campaign. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my bro David Camarena, who shot the campaign. It's dope to represent because you know what I'm saying, like. Everyone's able to see that because, like, you know, the Nike basketball ads, they go through everyone's Instagram, you know what I'm saying? Just because everyone who's, like, in that area or anyone who's, like, likes basketball, like, just, you know how ads work. Ads just come up.
And there you are,
man. Everyone's hitting me like, I see you on this Nike ad. And it's just, like, it's crazy just to be able to represent.
Shout out to David because David actually went on his very first tour with us.
Yes.
And now he's touring with Kehlani. Now, that's what's so dope about the Bay, man, is that from the outside in, and I don't know if it's like this actually being in there, from the outside in, it's like a lot of great teamwork, right?
Yeah.
I mean, between Kehlani and G-Eazy and the HBK and I Am Sue, even Lil B, like, it just seems like there's a lot of love in the Bay.
I mean, like we all came up, well, I mean, obviously we all came up in the Bay, and the Bay's never really had its, like, full potential shine. So everyone who understands that and knows that, like, we all we have is us. So like any chance we get to help each other, we're like, come on, you know what I'm saying? So it's a dope community. It's a dope, it's just a dope area, man. Shout out to everyone in the Bay Area. So oh, yeah,
man, that's amazing. I mean, one of my favorite places in the world, man. I mean, the food and all that. Now, speaking of Lil B, you saw Lil B recently had the little scuff with A Boogie.
Yeah.
And I gotta say, you know, a lot of people were talking about Cardi B that week because, you know, she got engaged. But yeah, I think one of the greatest moments in hip hop is 2017 is Lil B forgiving A Boogie right on stage. I mean, that I just feel like that is something that young people need to see, you know, with all the Xan rap and all the, you know, turn up, like, just to see someone like Lil B.
Real positive.
Have something positive, and I think that just stems from that kind of that Bay culture, man.
Yeah, you know, yeah, no, man, Lil B, man, shout out Lil B, first and foremost, for all the positivity that he's, like, brought to people, you know what I'm saying? And right. I feel like he hasn't fully got his recognition for the wave of rap that he created that's damn near the biggest wave of rap right now.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right,
and he's the one, that's where all that stems from. So
right.
Shout out Lil B. And man, for his like personality, for him to be the bigger person at that moment.
Dude, I'm telling you, that's a big moment in hip hop.
Yeah, that people aren't like gonna like really give its full credit, but man, that was such a big moment.
Right. Now, you know, when we were on tour together, what was dope is that we prided ourselves on being two Filipino kids on a hip-hop tour. And growing up, you know, I would say that Filipinos were definitely an influence in hip-hop, but people, they weren't necessarily the face of it.
Yeah.
You know, like you had Q-Bert and all those guys doing it in the Bay.
Yeah.
You had Brian Sampson doing crazy record promo over here.
Yeah.
but, you know, and I saw recently that you went back to the Philippines.
Yeah.
So just, can you like, in short, just tell me like, what's it, do you feel like, do you like kind of not think that's like something special? Or are you like not to think about it? Or are you like, yo, I'm Filipino, I'm here.
Yeah.
And then what was it like being in the Philippines kind of, you know, as the artist, you know?
Yeah, yeah, man, I recognize it as a moment and as a responsibility for me.
Right.
Because you know what I'm saying? Like you said, like, you know what I'm saying? Filipinos have been prominent in hip hop, but they never really got the like the forefront of it.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? So this is something that I recognize, and I'm like, okay, well, I know there's gonna be people following me,
right?
Following my footsteps,
right?
And I want to be able to give them like a vantage point, so where they can look at me and be like, okay, he did that. I can do the same thing,
right?
And then probably do it better. They're gonna probably do it better than whatever I did.
I mean, that's what Q-Bert and Shortcut and all those guys were for me as a DJ coming up in the late 90s, early 2000s, like because they did it, I could do it.
Yeah, off so, top. So like, I mean? You know what I'm saying? I know there's people coming.
Right.
You
and so how about in the Philippines, man? Were there a lot of fans?
Yeah, man, it was crazy. You know, it was dope because you know what I'm saying? Like we did two shows out there, and then the shows were crazy, and then we end up doing this like in store with Adidas, Adidas Philippines, and there were like hella people there. You know what I'm saying? And then, like, I didn't even know that, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't even know it was, like, that many people that fooled me out there. So it was cool just to be able to, like, represent, you know what I'm saying? Especially just being in the States, like, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people, they don't see that, you know what I'm saying? Right. Especially, like, a dominant Filipino, like, in the...
And hip-hop hasn't necessarily hit mainstream there.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
For them to see someone like you, man, it's got to be a big deal. You know, I went out there 2 years ago with Wiz, and Kanye. It was a Wiz and Kanye show, ironically.
Yeah, ironically.
And out of all, my mom is from a small town in the North Philippines, and to think like, yo, she came out of that.
Yeah.
Years later, I'm back with Wiz Khalifa touring. It's just, you know,
like
full
like,
circle moment.
Yeah,
you know
no, for sure. Like, I shot a video where my dad grew up at, recently, and I had just put it out, and it was just like, there was like, you know, we had the whole neighborhood out, and there was all these kids outside, and I'm like, man, like I was like really like,
could have been you.
Yeah, it could have been me, or my dad was one of those kids.
Right, and he got out. Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it was like a full circle moment for me, and I was just like absorbing all of that.
Right.
So it was cool for like to be in that position. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my dad and my
Perfect,
parents.
Perfect, man. Yeah. Before we get into this battle, which we're about to do,
vicious battle.
Real quick, for those of cats who never tried Filipino food, the top three Pilo Filipino foods that you need to try?
Off top, you gotta try sinigang.
Of course,
that's the number one. Number two, you gotta try chicken adobo.
That's my number one though.
For real?
Yeah, adobo.
Okay, yeah. Chicken adobo. I mean, and probably lumpia.
Lumpia?
Yeah.
Some egg rolls.
Yeah, that's pretty.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, that's pretty.
Well, shout out to my man Cool John, because I know he's a fan of this right here. And we about to battle. And just so you know, I've beaten ASAP Rocky. I've beaten Lil Yachty.
Okay.
So I'm pretty much undefeated when it comes to rappers.
Okay, well, you know what I'm saying?
We're about to go down.
Yeah.
My man P-Lo, your boy DJ Bonics is going to go head to head right here, Connect Four. What color you want to be, man? You want to be red or yellow?
I'll be yellow.
All right, you be yellow. All right, so since you're the guest here in Minnesota, I'm going to let you go first. How about that?
All right, let's go.
All right, here we go. Time to bring the bass back.
If they hating, got a price to pay. California on my license plate. Last year, they ain't even like the bay. Damn. But we don't never trip. All I know is gas break dip. No, we never trick on that. No, I can't quit. No, I don't fuck with that. But hey, put me on some. Put me on some. Put me on some.
Man, this is a tough one.
Go, man.
We're on a binger, guys.
I'm repping the cities right now.
We're on a binger.
Cities versus the city.
Oh
no. Dude.
It's a wrap.
It's a wrap, man.
It's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's a wrap.
Oh no.
It's a wrap. Yes.
My first loss. Big shout out to my man P-Lo. Thank you for coming to the Twin Cities, man. Congratulations on everything.
Appreciate you.
More than anything, grab the album now. Request it at Go95.3, man. Stream it. Buy the joint from my man P-Lo.
Big love.
Congratulations,
thank
man.
Thank you, man.
I'm really mad at him, though, for being here.
Thank you. Woo, that's an intense one.